Batman, The Dark Knight. Great movie. A little too long though. Batman, The Dark Knight. Good ride. A little too short though. Regardless, you'll leave this ride ending up wanting to blow up a hospital. Healthcare worker gowned and all. Batman, The Dark Knight debuted in 2002 at Six Flags New England. Back when I was wearing extra large FUBU t-shirts, looking like Nelly's disadvantaged little cousin. This ride is a 2,600 feet long B&M floorless coaster. You enter the park like, I'm going to the water park, but I might as well ride this ride because, you know, it's basically inside the water park. You pull up on this coaster, looking like a tasty bucket of Breyers Black Raspberry. Got me licking my lips and shit. You walk between this gothic gates with the Batman logo in the middle and what looks like two red grapes. You're waiting in line, you look at the superhero cardboard cutouts and you start reading and you read that first sentence and you're like, I ain't about to read this. Let's not play games here. Actually, let's play games here, waiting in this line on my phone because this line is taking forever. This ride has no mid-course break run and basically has to go through the entire course. I never had a problem with the inverted Batman clones. I never felt like the line really took that long, but Batman it did, even though there's not that many people. You make it to the station, strap in, and then the floor drops and scurry behind the walls like roaches do at my apartment. You rise up this chain lift and you look to the right and you notice there's a parking lot right here and I had to cross a whole street and everything. What the fuck? So then you look to the left and you see Mind Eraser and you're like, oh no, it's an SOC. I'd rather just look at the cars. You make it to the top of the 117 foot lift and you see beautiful Superman the Ride just doing its thing. You suddenly lower your expectations for the ride that you're currently on. You also see the Connecticut River and it's just like you hear Imagine Dragons singing in the background. I'm out to the river, and I'm out to the river, and the river, out to the river. You go down the pre-drop and it feels like you're on a rocking chair sitting holding some lemonade on a porch. And then you have this turning drop, which really works for this ride. It's more drop than it is turny, in my opinion. There's a ratio here, you know. At the bottom of the drop, you reach your top speed of 55 miles per hour and you enter this very circular vertical loop. This leads you into the dive loop, which is just peacefully compact. What gatekeeper should have done. Like, who has an incline dive loop? And you have a turnaround where you go through the vertical loop, you know, just because he can. It's just like Batman just toying with these criminals. Then you have a zero-G roll through the dive loop. Like, where they do that at? You gotta be careful with this one though, because if you're not positioned right, the shoulder restraints may just slightly pimp slap your jaw. After this maneuver, you take a right turn into a corkscrew. This is next to the midway. People are looking at you like, okay, you lit, you lit. All right, I see you. Then there's a turn, there's another corkscrew. Interlocking corkscrews. All the inversions are interlocking, interconnected. You know, American politics should take notes. And then it ends. Already? What is this, some animated special? Like, I would understand if this ride was themed to Robin, but like, really? I complain, it's like the floorless version of the inverted Batman clones, which aren't that long either. 5 inversions. And I love those, so we gooch. The pacing on this ride is beautiful. There's never a dull moment. You know, I felt like I was on Love and Hip Hop. But at the same time, it's a weird position in the park. It's right next to the water park. A lot of times, hot summer days, the water park is just packed. And so that whole area is just so crowded for no reason. It's a dead end when it comes to the dry park. And again, I said it's kind of short. Overall, I'll rate this ride a... kick ass! Tell me how you like this video, comment below, put them thumbs up, make sure that notification bell is on. Please share, don't forget to share. If you thought I was Caleb Reese, hit subscribe and I'll come back with a new video.